Virgos, hey you guys, come on in, come on in. Let's get a quick read for you guys today. What is going on? What is going on? Hi, Virgo. I hope y'all are doing amazing. Sending you guys love, light, and positive energy as always. Let's go ahead and get into your message. I pray that each and every one of you are well and God is giving you the desires of your heart. Let's see. What is going on for Virgo? Virgo, what's the message? New love or a recommitment to love, Virgo, is developing. So you guys could have met a new love. Somebody new has sparked your interest or you have sparked somebody else's interest. You guys, I feel it's a mutual thing. All right. You met somebody new, some of you guys. And this new love could be something that you are passionate about, something new that's happening for you in your life. All right. Whatever a new love is, it doesn't always have to be romantic. It could definitely be something new that you have, something new that has entered your life that's making you emotionally fulfilled. So let's see what's going on. I mean, these are love cards, though. They're about your relationships. So this definitely could be you meeting somebody new. Okay, period. Let's see what else. Let me move the camera up a little bit more. All right, let's see what else, Virgo. This one popped out too. Vulnerability. So you can be very vulnerable with this person. It says you can be completely vulnerable with this person, whoever this is that you may have met as of lately. Let's see what else. I don't need to shuffle them right now. What else does Virgo need to see about their connection? So this is about somebody who's met a new love, all right, or a recommitment to love, because we got this relationship deserves a second chance. So I see somebody here circling the block, maybe. I feel like it's unfinished business here between you two, whoever this is. And this is somebody new that feels like they didn't get the fair opportunity with you. I feel like somebody doesn't want you to forget about them. This person still has you on their mind. And they definitely want an opportunity to have love with you. I feel like this person is definitely wanting you to know that. Right? This is what I'm feeling when it comes to you and this person. This person wants you to know that they want a second chance. But underneath the bottom of the deck, Virgo, I have to show you this. It's saying don't dismiss the red flags here between you and this person or something about this person that you want to pay attention to. Don't dismiss the red flags. So it's something that's happening in plain sight and you need to really take heed to the message. Pay attention to it. Let's see what else is up. What's going on? What is going on with the red flags here between Virgo and this person? Let's take a look. What's happening with this energy between Virgo and their person? And for those of you who met a new love, make sure you're taking your time. Don't rush it. Ask the proper questions is what I'm getting to tell you. I feel like you met somebody and they give you this feeling of nostalgia, kind of. Maybe a nostalgic feeling or like, you know how back in the day you used to talk on the phone for hours? I feel like you're feeling this energy with this person. I feel like you guys are really finding a lot of similarities in your walk. All right, your walk, your life walk, your path, okay? I feel like you guys have experienced some of the same things and you like that. But the thing is, somebody may be wearing a mask, all right? So be careful. And somebody may be secretly bring you on as a side piece, male or female energy. Somebody could be just planning to date you as somebody on the side. It says this opportunity or this situation but deserve a second chance because I feel like at the time things didn't get off the ground like they should have. But now somebody could possibly be dealing with somebody else. This is just letting you know that this energy is around. It's coming towards you. This is what you don't see coming, right? So this new love or a new recommitment to love is developing. So I feel like you've been talking to this person. You guys could have reconnected with somebody from the past as well. But with the warning, don't dismiss the red flags here. It has something to do with somebody wearing a mask. I feel like this is somebody who could be pretending, kind of two-faced, putting up a front, maybe not really showing you how they really feel. And then side piece, this is somebody that flirts with others or has a mistress or somebody wants you to be a mistress. The other woman in a secret hookup. So I feel like this is what this person really wants. They're not really showing you how they really feel. And with this blind card, I feel like you don't know. And you're searching for the truth. You're trying to really figure out, is this person with somebody? Do they have somebody? Are they lying to me? All right, because this person is fine. I feel like whoever met somebody new, they look good. And you're just like, this seems too good to be true. And there is a little bit of things that there's a few things that this person isn't exposing. And in all fairness, for both parties, whoever it may be, it could be you, it could be the other person. It's like everybody holds back certain things when they first meet somebody. Nobody comes in exposing every single thing about themselves. It's like you want to be careful. You want to make sure this is somebody you could trust. You want to make sure this is somebody you can confide in. And so this is the energy that I'm picking up on, but it's a big secret, okay? It's big. All right, you could be saying 11/11. Your birthday could be on the 11th day. This person could be born in the 11th month, but the number 11 could be significant, or you've been seeing number synchronicities. Let's see. Show me more. One more for Virgo with this energy down below. All right. So, surprise, an unexpected action, spontaneous showing up, or some type of unexpected change. I feel like this could have happened as you guys were talking. It's something that happened. This change between you guys is unexpected. But you want to know the truth. You want to know what's really good, what's up with this person, what have they been doing. So don't be, listen, make sure you remember I told you this because somebody's going to pop up unexpectedly. They could just be sending you a message trying to reconnect, but someone's going to pop up unexpectedly. I feel like this is going to be a welcomed re-entry, and I feel like you guys are going to be talking, reconnecting. But the energy here is don't forget that there are red flags. Don't ignore the red flags here. Somebody here is looking for a secret hookup, or they have somebody and they're making you the person on the side. Okay. For a select few of you guys, you're trying to recommit to your relationship, and this person has not been telling you the full truth. There is something going on, and your intuition was correct. That's for a select few of you. So let's check vulnerability. What's the energy surrounding vulnerability? Needing time. So, yes, you may feel like you can be open with this person. Y'all can talk about everything. It's a very divine connection when it comes to communication and meeting each other halfway and resonating with each other. However, this is saying needs time. Now is not the time. Time will bring unexpected changes, something that you don't see coming. All right. So before you fully open up to this person, keep that in mind. All right. If you feel like you need a reading, more tailored to your own personal situation, you could book it at Closer, the number 2mydestiny.com. Show me the energy surrounding this new love or recommitment to love. It says there's a spell or negativity. It's something here where somebody is doing something to try to ruin it, or there's some type of negativity, something trying to get in the way of this. Dang, y'all. And I feel like the negativity is because this person is sneaky. Fake profile, hiding from you, behind the scenes, social media. So somebody could be doing their research, looking up your name, trying to find out what's really going on with you or see what you're really into. Somebody is trying to search you on social media or just see what else they can find out about you aside from what you're telling them. Or this is you that need to do your research and realize that this person is sneaky. Dang. That's the negativity, because with this witchcraft card, it could just be simply talking about manipulation. It's not always talking about a spell. All right. So, second chance. This relationship deserves a second chance. Foresight in the future, a few days to weeks, a few months. So, somebody is definitely coming towards you. All right. And you're going to have to make a decision whether or not you're welcoming this person back, or are you just going to dismiss them altogether? Let's get the tarot out and see what's going on. Look at this. Degrading appearances, shame, and humiliation. Let's see what's under this. Oh, leaving behind, disappearing, cold, and no contact. Okay. So somebody is shameful and they kind of ghosted. Look, forbidden love affair. You could have ghosted this person because you don't want to be a third party. But here they come again, and I feel like they're reeling you back in. You guys are talking. And it's like nothing to talk about for real. Let's see what you need, what else the tea is about this person. What else is going on with Virgo and this person? What is going on with Virgo and this person? Let's use these small tarot cards and clarify. So what does Virgo need to know about vulnerability, being very vulnerable with this person? What's going on here? So we got the Eight of Pentacles in reverse. Something's not working. It says needing time. Now is not the time. Time will bring unexpected changes. So it's something about this working with this person with the Eight of Pentacles in reverse. This could be definitely stagnant energy. This could be a warning that something won't work. If you try to go toward this person, maybe it won't work. This is also a lack of long-term vision or some type of dissatisfaction. And I feel like this is how you feel. You feel like it just doesn't, won't work. It could be something where you're not satisfied with this person and how they move. What else about the Eight of Pentacles in reverse? Dang, this flipped over in reverse too. Gossip, negative, some type of unfavorable news or spying or something that someone found out. Show me witchcraft and sneaky. Wow, we got the High Priest. So somebody could definitely be doing with somebody, dealing with somebody that does spell work. What's witchcraft and new love? But somebody is wishing for this. You wanted this really bad. But look, the Emperor. This could be somebody who is already in a relationship. This is somebody who could possibly be married. And this could be what you're finding out. With the High Priest, this represents a higher level of commitment. This is my marriage card. You know, this is representing like marriage. And you could be doing a spell to make this person come back to you. I told y'all about doing those spells. You got to be careful. Like somebody is sneaky, spying, having a fake account. You could be spying on this person to find out what's going on. And with this, the moon energy here, secrets and betrayal with the Ten of Swords. Somebody could be finding out that somebody secretly betrayed them. All right. And this is why you walked away. But in the near future, it's going to be an opportunity for you to talk back to this person if it hasn't already happened. And I feel like you need to know that this person's keeping secrets. Somebody is, and somebody could be talking to somebody online. Look what's popping out. Let's see what these cards say. The Magician, the Page of Pentacles, the Nine of Pentacles. All right. So with the Magician, a manipulator, somebody could be trying to manipulate you or trying to persuade you to do something because they have foresight with the Three of Wands. Your ships are coming in. I feel like somebody, or they feel like they're waiting for their ships to come in. Somebody's waiting for you to take the bait and come down their direction. Like they're trying to reel you in. I feel like somebody is literally trying to sweet talk you and get you to do things their way. And it's like you're blind to this. This secret, it's like when this secret comes out, it's going to change everything. You could definitely really want this. With this blind, what is blind and a surprise? So this person, for some of you guys, this is telling you to be strong and tame the beast. Because this is your emotional fulfillment. Somebody really, really loves this person. You allowed yourself to fall in love or just have a great liking for this person. Like a deep, deep emotion. Like deep feelings for this person. Be strong because I feel like you guys have been intimate or you really want to be intimate with this person. So something is going to happen. It's going to be very tempting. All right, they're going to surprise you. It's going to come out of nowhere. Or for some of you guys, you're going to get a surprise that's going to make you very happy. All right, it's going to be very exciting. Show me warning. Don't dismiss the red flags here with the Justice card. This is talking about you weighing all the facts. The Justice card is telling you to weigh all the facts, pay attention to the details, make a just decision. That's going to be best for both of you guys. And with the Four of Cups, this is saying make sure that you choose wisely. I feel like this is saying, honestly, justice is yours. Remember why you walked away, I feel. Remember the balanced decision you made in the first place. This is why you're not talking to this person. You're being told to remember how they are. Like, don't forget just because things are going well right now. All right? And the Four of Cups. And remember when I told you somebody could be using manipulation with the witchcraft? We got the Magician here. All right? So somebody could really be using love spells or just trying to manipulate you with illusions and confusion. And with the Four of Cups, this is telling you you might want to reconsider. If you're thinking about going down this path with this person, you definitely might want to reconsider. Why is the Four of Cups here for Virgo? You got the Queen of Wands. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And the King of Wands. So both of you, like, don't mind. I feel like this King of Wands and Queen of Wands is here because you see each other on the side. And this is telling you, warning, don't dismiss the red flags. Reconsider seeing this person and being their side piece. Like, don't lower your standards like that. You're going to confuse the universe and you're going to be right back in a toxic cycle with this person or in a toxic cycle with this person. I feel like somebody here dodged a bullet one time and this reading is telling you to learn your lesson or you'll be sorry. All right, learn your lesson about this person or you will be sorry. Somebody needs to let it go. Eight of Pentacles in reverse and the Page of Swords in reverse. What's the gossip about? What's the heartbreak? Spying. Yeah, somebody is going to end up heartbroken with the Page of Swords. This is telling you, like, I feel like it's telling you don't go toward this person. It's not going to work. Eight of Pentacles in reverse, Page of Swords in reverse. It's like you already found out enough information to steer you away from this person. And this is saying, don't ignore the red flags. So they're going to come towards you. They're very sneaky. Somebody's trying to be crafty here. And really, they only want a side piece. Somebody is in a relationship. Either they're married or you're married. Somebody's already married. All right. Show me what Virgo needs to know about this situation for the high. Wait, with the mask. What's being hidden? This is somebody putting up a front. Just playing the field. Like they're not being honest. But the Five of Wands bringing that mental confusion. Yeah, because this is what they want. A passionate new beginning. Passionate new beginning. They don't really want the Ace of Pentacles. And here it is. Somebody coming back, revisiting you from the past, thinking about you, wanting to move forward, wanting to do something else, like wanting to get back together, maybe talk some more. Somebody remembers how fiery and passionate your relationship used to be, or they know, like, they've been talking to you, so they see you slowly opening up, and it's a test to see if you're going to take the bait. So this reading is a warning for you to learn your lesson from the first time and do not go back from something that God already removed you from, okay? Show me what Virgo needs to see for their highest good. It's like you got rescued one time, this time you won't. Yeah, ignore this person. It's like you're refusing to make the tough decision. That's what the Two of Swords could stand for. This could also be telling you to use your intuition. This person is using their intuition and they're guarded. So it's saying, like, protect your heart and use your intuition. Don't be emotional. All right. Don't be in your emotions, but be logical. What else does Virgo need to know for their highest good? What else? Move away from the conflict, the arguing, the stress. It's time for you to move on to calmer waters. Make a decision to choose you. Some of you guys are in hermit mode. This is telling you that it's time for some self-introspect, time for some self-reflection, time to go within so you can really see this situation for what it is. All right. This is basically telling you to be wise. All right, allow yourself to heal. It's like you have the potential to have whatever you want. And you do shine bright. And yes, we understand why a lot of people are interested. However, this is reminding you to choose wisely, heal yourself, protect your energy, and love you first with the Star card. It's all about rejuvenation, restoration, hopefulness. And honestly, nobody ever really reads it like that, but the Star card is also representing something that can't be healed, all right? With the World card, this is a successful completion of the cycle. So it's good for you to move toward this energy, go ahead and close this situation out for good, and you'll have another opportunity coming right after you close that door. Transformation, all right? I love you guys. Thanks for being here with me, and I will see you on the next video. Bye, my lovies.